Good morning. You may have noticed Pastor Jenny is not me, and I'm not Pastor Jenny. She's at annual conference this morning, so I'm glad all of you are here this morning and ready for church here at Stuart-Mount Vernon United Methodist Church. We need to welcome our online viewers, so if you can all wave to our online viewers and welcome them this morning. And also, remember that we need to be in a time of worship. And so I'm going to light the candle. And for those of you, if you have any prayer requests or prayer concerns, there are prayer cards in pews for you to be able to write those down. Let us know if you have any concerns at this time. At this time, we will now have a meditation.
Take a deep breath. Spend a moment recognizing God's presence in this place with us. Hear these words from Psalm 139. Lord, you have examined me. You know me. You know when I sit down and when I stand up. Even from far away, you comprehend my plans. You study my traveling and resting. You are thoroughly familiar with all my ways. There isn't a word on my tongue, Lord, that you don't already know completely. You surround me, front and back. You put your hand on me. That kind of knowledge is too much for me. It's so high above me that I can't reach it. Spend a moment reflecting on the way you have been created, that this is wonderful. Ask God to help you and to celebrate together the wonder of your unique identity as God's beloved creation. Gracious God, you have made each one of us in your glorious image. You search us and know us. You know all our anxious thoughts. Help us put these to rest now as we turn our hearts and minds to focus on you and your abundant love for us. We praise you and thank you for Jesus. It is in his name we pray. Amen.
Please join us in hymn number 57, Oh for a Thousand Tongues to Sing.
Thank you.
And please join me in the prayer of confession. God, we long to follow you, to walk in the way that you have shown us, to know your commandments, and to practice them wholeheartedly. But we confess that we are easily distracted, lured away by our own interests and desires, enticed by the attitudes and practices of the world around us. Forgive us. Turn our eyes away from the things that distract us from your way, from the attitudes and behaviors that sidetrack us from our desire to know you better and follow you more closely. Give us a hunger for your word and your ways. Show us where true life and happiness are found, in knowing and doing your will. Amen. You may be seated. And we would like the children to come forward at this time with Miss Lori.
Good morning. Good morning. How are you? Your hair's so cute. Good morning, guys. Associate, all of the children. Okay, well, we have a small group, and I have, where's Grace?
Birthday party.
Oh, okay. How about the rest of your family? Where's Mac?
Mac went to a baseball.
Okay. All right, well, I'm glad that you guys are here. So today, I want to talk a little bit about goodness. And last night, I was at this store. Do you recognize what that symbol means? Store, do you know? With the H?
I know what it is. Hy-Vee.
Hy-Vee, yes. I was at Hy-Vee, and I was really hungry for a snack, and I thought, what sounds good? And so I couldn't quite make up my mind. So I got this. What is it?
Chocolate.
Yeah, it's a chocolate Hershey bar. It says milk chocolate on it. And I thought, well, that sounds really good. So I actually got a couple of those. Two Hershey bars. And then I thought, but maybe I want something else. So I got this. And what kind of candy bar is this?
Snickers.
Yeah. And I don't know. How many of you guys like chocolate? Like chocolate?
I like chocolate.
No? Kind of? Okay. Well, today we're going to talk a little bit about God's goodness. And because most people think that chocolate is very good, I'm going to take these three candy bars, and we're going to do a little experiment with them and talk about it. So, Ike, will you open that one for me, please, and put it on the on one of the plates? Yep, the whole thing. Kind of got broke up on the way. Okay, I'm going to give you this knife, and I want you to cut that candy bar up for me and tell me what you find in it, okay?
It looks like chocolate.
Looks like chocolate, doesn't it? Yep, just plain chocolate, right? No matter where you cut it or where it breaks, inside is just chocolate. Thank you. So this chocolate is like God's love. God is good, and God loves us no matter what, right? And it doesn't matter what choices we make or what we do, God loves us. And his love, and God is always good. And nothing changes about that. Now, Charlie, I'm going to give you this one. And I'm going to have you do the same thing, hopefully. The knife will cut it. If it doesn't, we'll, I have a pair of scissors. Okay, so, okay, if you can't cut, if it won't cut, I've got scissors you can cut it with. Okay, that's good enough. Okay, so now I want you to look inside that one, Charlie, for me, and tell me what you see in there.
Chocolate, nuts, and like caramel, and some weird white.
Okay.
Thing, majig, I don't know.
Yeah, they call that nougat. thank you. So this candy bar is kind of like us. On the outside, it looks like pure chocolate, right? Like we're being good. And we try to be good, don't we? But on the inside of us, there's other stuff that gets in our way of being good. Like when I see that peanut, it makes me think of when I was supposed to be putting away garage sale stuff yesterday, and I was playing Candy Crush instead. Right? So what's something, can you think of a time? Are you going to cut it for me? Thanks, sweetie. Can you think of a time when you guys maybe weren't completely good or made a different choice?
Yeah.
What can you think of?
When sometimes I get mad at my parents.
Okay. Yep. Sometimes when our parents tell us to do things and they say it's for our own good, we kind of get angry, and so it's hard to be good all the time, right? How about you guys? Can you think of anything? No? That's okay. All right. Then we have this one. Looks like a regular Hershey's candy bar, doesn't it? Okay. Is that okay that she's eating chocolate? Okay. it feels a little weird in there, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Looks good on the outside. But if we're thinking about chocolate being good, can you open that one for me? I've got scissors too if you want to use scissors. Because that one's been, it looks like it's been tampered with a little bit. Oh my goodness. What's inside there?
Ooh. Shortbread.
Yeah, shortbread cookies. So on the outside, it looked good. And we've got people like that look really good on the outside. But on the inside, they're completely not what we were expecting. So what we want to remember is that God is good all the time, right? Okay, can we bow our head and say a prayer? Dear God. Thank you for being good all the time. We are glad that we have your love as we go through life. Amen. And to help you.
We'll now enjoy some special music from Teresa.
When troubles surround us, when evils come, the body grows weak, the spirit grows numb. When these things beset us, he doesn't forget us, he sends us his love on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow-white dove, he sends his pure, sweet love from above on the wings of a dove. When Noah had drifted on the flood many days, he searched for land in various ways. Troubles he had some, but wasn't forgotten. He sent him his love on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow-white dove. He sends his pure, sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove. When Jesus went down the waters that day, he was baptized in the usual way. When it was done, God left his son. He sent him his love on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a white dove. He sends his pure, sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a dove.
Thank you, Teresa. That was beautiful. We will now be entering into a psalms and songs. A psalm will be read, and then a song will follow that, and some different people will be up here helping me out. So our first one is Psalm 145. I will lift you up high, my God, the true King. I will bless your name forever and always. I will bless you every day. I will praise your name forever and always. The Lord is great and so worthy of praise. God's greatness can't be grasped. One generation will praise your works to the next one, proclaiming your mighty acts. They will talk all about you, the glorious splendor of your majesty. I will contemplate your wondrous works. They will speak of the power of your awesome deeds. I will declare your great accomplishments. They will rave in celebration of your abundant goodness. They will shout joyfully about your righteousness. The Lord is merciful and compassionate, very patient and full of faithful love. The Lord is good to everyone and everything. God's compassion extends to all his handiwork. All that you have made gives thanks to you, Lord. All your faithful ones bless you. They speak of the glory of your kingdom. They talk all about your power, to inform all human beings about God's power and the majestic glory of God's kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingship that lasts forever. Your rule endures for all generations. The Lord is trustworthy in all that he says, faithful in all that he does. The Lord supports all who fall down, straightens up all who are bent low. All eyes look to you hoping, and you give them their food right on time, opening your hand and satisfying the desire of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all his ways, faithful in all his deeds. The Lord is close to everyone who calls out to him, to all who call out to him sincerely. God shows favor to those who honor him, listening to their cries for help and saving them. The Lord protects all who love him, but he destroys every wicked person. My mouth will proclaim the Lord's praise, and every living thing will bless God's holy name forever and always. Psalm 145 is a powerful symphony of praise and testimony. It is a cry of joy, proclaiming God's kindness, righteousness, faithfulness, majesty, glory, and love. This psalm comes from the heart of one who is complete awe of God, and the admiration and praise is contagious. Verse 4 says, "One generation commends your works to another. They tell of your mighty acts. There is a beauty in knowing that we are not in the first generation to sing. We are not the first generation to sing God's praise, but we know and sing His praises because of generations that came before us, faithfully proclaiming the Lord. We seek to be that same generation who can say to God that we speak awesome works, proclaim your great deeds, celebrate your abundant goodness, and joyfully sing of your righteousness. Let us remain seated and sing hymn number 154, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name.
I'll be reading Psalm 40. I put all my hope in the Lord. He leaned down to me. He listened to my cry for help. He lifted me out of the pit of death, out of the mud and filth, and set my feet on solid rock. He steadied my legs. He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise for our God. Many people will learn of this and be amazed. They will trust the Lord. Those who put their trust in the Lord, who pay no attention to the proud or those who follow lies, are truly happy. You, Lord my God, you've done so many things, your wonderful deeds and your plans for us. No one can compare with you. If I were to proclaim and talk about all of them, they would be too numerous to count. You don't relish sacrifices or offerings. You don't require entirely burned offerings or compensation offerings. But you have given me ears. So I said, here I come. I'm inscribed in the written scroll. I want to do your will, my God. Your instruction is deep within me. I've told the good news of your righteousness in the great assembly. I didn't hold anything back, as you well know, Lord. I didn't keep your righteousness only to myself. I declared your faithfulness and your salvation. I didn't hide your loyal love and trustworthiness from the great assembly. So now you, Lord, don't hold back any of your compassion from me. Let your loyal love and faithfulness always protect me because countless evils surround me. My wrongdoings have caught up with me. I can't see a thing. There's more of them than hairs on my head. My courage leaves me. Favor me, Lord, and deliver me. Lord, come quickly and help me. Let those who seek my life, who want me dead, be disgraced and put to shame. Let those who want to do me harm be thoroughly frustrated and humiliated. Let those who say yes to me, yes, oh yes, be destroyed by their shame. But let all who seek you celebrate and rejoice in you. Let those who love your salvation always say, the Lord is great. But me, I'm weak and needy. Let my Lord think of me. You are my help and my rescuer. My God, don't wait any longer. Psalm 40 begins with a proclamation of faith and trust. I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. How many times have we all wondered if God is really there, if God really hears our cries for help? Psalm 40 reminds us he is there and he does hear. Verse 2 continues, he lifted me out of the slimy pit, out of the mud and mire. He set my feet on a rock and gave me a firm place to stand. We are reminded in Psalm 40 that not only does he hear us, he cares for us individually and will act in his time and according to his will. Knowing that the all-powerful, universe-creating God cares for each of us, hears our cries, and pulls us up out of the pit, inspires us to sing and praise. We see this response in verse 3. He put a new song in my mouth, a hymn of praise to our God. Please sing with me hymn number 369, Blessed Assurance, verses 1 and 3.
The third psalm is Psalm 8. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name throughout the earth. You made your glory higher than heaven. From the mouths of nursing babies, you have laid a strong foundation before because of your foes in order to stop vengeful enemies. When I look up at your skies, at what your fingers made, the moon and the stars that you set firmly in place. What are human beings that you think about them? What are human beings that you pay attention to them? You've made them only slightly less than divine, crowning them with glory and grandeur. You've let them rule over your handiwork, putting everything under their feet, all sheep and all cattle, the wild animals too, the birds in the sky, the fish of the ocean, everything that travels the paths of the sea. Lord, O Lord, how majestic is your name throughout the earth. Psalm 8 holds a special place in our hearts of many believers, and it asks a question we have all likely asked. What does an almighty God even care for us? Verses 3 and 4 state this beautifully. When I consider the heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have set in place. What is mankind that you are mindful of them? Human beings that you care for them. It is a reminder of a wonderful truth that we are all in need of grace, yet each of us is created in the image of God and is God's creation bearing his image. God cares deeply for each and every one of us. It is humbling and draws us into worship and praise. Let's sing hymn number 92, For the Beauty of the Earth, verses 1 and 6.
Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise God in his fortress, the sky. Praise God in his mighty acts. Praise God that suits his incredible greatness. Praise God. Praise God with the blast of the ram's horn. Praise God with the lute and lyre. Praise God with the drum and dance. Praise God with the strings and pipe. Praise God with the loud cymbals. Praise God with the clashing cymbals. But let everything praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It is fitting that the final chapter in Psalms should finish the list of this psalmist, the favorite of many worship leaders and musicians. In general, the word praise is repeated 13 times in these 6 verses and speaks to a passionate celebration and praise to God. We praise the Lord for his holiness and praise him in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Do I read it? 150 through 1. Let us continue praising God by singing hymn 62, all creatures of our God and King.
Thank you.
affirmation of faith. Affirmation of faith, number 881. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. At this time, we will now praise God through our offering. Please join me in the prayer of thanksgiving. Merciful God, the gifts we bring are so small in comparison to the vast needs in our world. Yet we have brought what we can. Multiply these gifts so that the hungry may receive all they need and more. Amen. Please join me in number 657. This is the day.
Thank you.
You may be seated. Any announcements we have this morning? What? What was that? It's your birthday. I heard that. Is that right? It's Jackson's birthday. How old are you today, Jackson? 4 years old. All right. Yeah. Whew. Four on the fourth. Is that right? June 4th, 4th. What? Golden birthday. That is fabulous. I love it. When I saw that this week, I was like, oh my gosh, Jackson's turning four on the fourth. I was so excited. All right. It looks like it's our summer series is Make an Adventure Jesus next Sunday at 9:30. That sounds like a good time. I've been reading up on that. Anything else? Ada Hansen on the 5th. How old are you going to be, Ada? You're not supposed to ask a lady how old. How old are you going to be? 14? Oh, sweet. Woohoo! Yes, ma'am. Oh, okay. Let's do her.
And also Suzanne.
Oh, Suzanne's is June 7th, right? We won't ask how old Suzanne is. We won't go there. Happy birthday. Other announcements? I see up here too that we have the best pop ever on June 18th. That is Father's Day, but come and join us for all fun games and shaving and all kinds of good stuff.
What? Go ahead.
Go ahead. You want to present that? Okay, go ahead. Are you all done? Yep. If there aren't any other announcements, I'll let Jana take over and present our award to us here.
Friday night was laity night at annual conference, and I'm lay delegate. I have been for the past 2 or 3 years. But we had a special recognition that we were told about a few weeks ago. So you already know it. I think most of you do. The pastor had announced it. But there were around 20 of us at the session that started at 7 on Friday night in West Des Moines. And we were presented with what's called the number one Matters Award. And it's really neat. I tried not to get fingerprints on it when they presented it. And there was also a check that was given to us as well. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to say the amount, $1,000. And I would say, yeah, go ahead. Melissa Drake, our superintendent for Aldersgate, is the one that nominated us. And in her presentation, what she said was Pastor Jenny had called her different times to tell her, there's these baptisms that's happened, here's what's happened, we've had these many people join our church. And so we can also give credit to our superintendent for nominating us, because this was an award for the whole state of Iowa, and it's only one that's given like this. So I do think we've been blessed with a lot of things that's led up to this, the pastors we've had, the laity that we have, the people that are willing to work together, and young families in the church with young kids. It's neat to get to hear those little voices in church. So I think I thought it would be appropriate to put it here in the altar. One Matters, it's a Discipleship Ministries Award, and it's really hard to see this because it's pretty clear. But it's forming disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. And that is our mission statement. So feel free to come up and look at it. I think that was just a... And session is going on yesterday all day and today too. So again.
All right. Any other announcements? This is quite an honor. I mean, just listening to all the things that were said on Friday night, we are blessed to have received such a great award for this church, and it's for everybody in here, our whole church family, which is so exciting for me. All right. Number 2241, the Spirit sends us forth to serve. can stand up and sing, and we'll belt it out, and then we'll be ready to go. Everyone have a great week.